Healing the divide between law enforcement and communities they serve, Old Dominion University released a study that shows most of Hampton Roads people trust their officers, but that data paints a much different picture when broken down by race. 10 on Your Side's Tamara Scott explains why.
The George Floyd killing and the protests that followed have left an incredible impact on our nation. And through this yearly survey, it seems it left a big impact on our local communities.
Seems like it's always in that two-thirds to three-quarters, at least for the region as a whole.
Tansy Vandekar Burton with ODU Research Center says this year, like many years past, Hampton Roads for the most part trusts their local police and how they operate. But unlike other years, this year they broke down this perception by race.
When we look at police satisfaction, nearly half of white respondents reported that they were very satisfied with police, compared to only about 13% of our black or African American respondents. So that's a very big difference there.
Trust for police had a similar breakdown.
When we look at trust, over half of our white respondents report that they trust the police a great deal, compared to just over 10% of our black or African American respondents.
They issued these surveys between June 26 and July 13th, right in the midst of the George Floyd protests across the country. I asked if those events may have played a part in this discrepancy.
I think it certainly could have, yes, because, you know, given the national attention that it received, and of course the local response here with, you know, many protests around the region.
So they asked questions about how people felt about the local protests.
And we saw that more than three quarters of people did say that they were supportive of the protests. Interestingly, also three quarters also said that they thought that the police were doing a good job in handling those protests.
Vandekar Burton says they also took into account people's personal experiences with police. One third of black respondents said they had a negative experience, while only 12% of white respondents reported a negative experience. Now, there are two other surveys yet to be released by ODU. You can expect to see one about health and COVID-19 and the economy in the next couple of weeks. Tamara Scott, 10 on Your Side.